This is On the Rock Sassy Movie News, your weekly Hollywood dish from the gay perspective. Who got cast? Who got fired? What movie's coming next? Who broke up with who? You know, the important stuff. Grab the popcorn and let's get started.
Well, hello, hello. This is On the Rocks Movie News, brought to you by Outat.TV. I'm your host, Alexander Rodriguez, bringing you the top and bottom in Hollywood news. Here's the latest Hollywood tea. Anne Hathaway revealed that she was the 9th choice to star in The Devil Wears Prada. Their first choice? Rachel McAdams. They obviously were not concerned with casting somebody who could act. No, that wasn't a question. Beep. Nightmare Before Christmas is getting a sequel. Calm down. It's in book form, and it's all about Sally's adventures. But the book is coming out, so there's probably a film down the way. Get ready, emo Disneylanders. P.S. I think Disney emo people are the most hilarious. I'm so dark and emo and troubled because I love Nightmare Before Christmas, but I love Disney musicals and wearing mouse ears. Meh. Speaking of odd people, the director of Hereditary and Midsommar, the strangest films to come out since Barb Wire, will be teaming up with other oddball Joaquin Phoenix for his next film called Disappointment Boulevard. Girl, that's probably what Joaquin's ex-girlfriends call his driveway. That dude is weird. Spider-Man cutie Tom Holland auditioned for the role of Finn in Star Wars. We know that John Boyega was cast, and apparently during Tom Holland's 4th or 5th audition, they had a number of auditions for the trilogy, he got the giggles because he was reading a scene alongside somebody reading as a drone. Beep, beep, bop, bop. It got to him so badly that he couldn't stop laughing, and he totally boffed it. Too bad. I would have loved to have seen Tom Holland grab hold of a lightsaber. Speaking of Spider-Verse and Star Wars' Daisy Ridley has made it known that she would love to play Spider-Woman in Sony's Marvel Universe movie. Star Wars money and Marvel money? Work, girl. Call me. The trailer for Disney's Cruella came out, and it's an origin story starring Emma Stone. It hit the scene and everybody went crazy. It looks sassy and sexy, and drag queens already shitting themselves to put together the outfits, but there's a huge faction of Disneyites saying that is not Cruella, that it's heresy. Girl, you know that Cruella's a fictional character, right? In a cartoon? Is there a new Star Trek The Next Generation movie in the works? Star Trek actor Brent Spiner, who played Data in The Next Generation and Picard, he firmly believes that The Next Generation will get a reboot, just like the original crew did for J.J. Abrams in those films. I would love to see Tom Hardy play Commander Riker, and maybe James Marsden as Data. You know, Data was built to be anatomically correct. Engage. Stanley Kubrick, responsible for 2001, A Clockwork Orange, Doctor Strangelove, and The Shining, has a new film coming out. Oh, wait. He died 20 years ago. But one of his archived screenplays, a film noir thriller called Lunatic at Large, is going into production. Is this like the Jurassic Park of Hollywood personalities? Just recreate their film DNA with a little scrap of something left over? Well, we know how that ended up. And here's a little behind-the-scenes factoid to leave you with. It took 8.5 hours from Jim Carrey's makeup and How the Grinch Stole Christmas to put on. Jim Carrey was so exhausted after his first day of filming, he smashed up his trailer and he was angry and he told Ron Howard, the director, that he couldn't do it. So their response? They hired a CIA operative specializing in surviving torture techniques to help him with the process, to go through that torture. That was their answer. Yikes. That has been our On the Rocks movie news. I'm Alexander Rodriguez. Check out my show On the Rocks with Alexander, where celebrities and cocktails mix every week on Outat.TV, Apple TV, Roku, and Amazon Fire TV for free. Stay sexy, stay healthy, and we'll see you at the movies.